Welcome to another edition of Scary Scouse Story. I remember most of these stories are factual and true, changed their names to protect the innocents, but they are mostly backed up by other people's statements and the corroboration. But please note, don't let these stories scare you too much. Please sleep tight after you've listened to them. So this one begins when I was 22. With my girlfriend, who I'll protect and not call her first name, I'll just be my girlfriend, and fell in love and got engaged. Now, back in them days, this is in the 1980s, there's a thing called the pools, getting score draws with football teams, and they're all saying you can win the pools, and that's basically my girlfriend won the pools. She won £10,000, which was back then was a hell of a lot of money. It's a hell of a lot of money now, but back then, wow. So she said, let's go on holiday. I thought, where should we go? And we decided, after many weeks of thinking, and should we go abroad, should we stay in England, Scotland, Wales, whatever, and yeah, we go abroad, Corfu. Now, I'd never flown before, it's a little bit scared if you like, yeah, because I've never flew before, and, but it was worth it. I was with a girlfriend, she just won the pools, and I was happy, and we booked the flight, everything, and we're going like first class, and 2 days before we were supposed to go, we got a phone call from the travel agent saying, awful sorry, there's been a double booking, and unfortunately they'll have to refund the money we paid to go there. I was shocked and horrified. My girlfriend, why? Well, back in them days, they used to be, they could double book to ensure the plane and the holiday was fully booked. Unfortunately, someone took our place, it's like a lottery, so we couldn't go. And we were gutted, absolutely gutted. My first chance of flying, going to Corfu. Anyway, so we decided to go to York instead. A little bit sad, a little bit depressed, but we booked lovely, what was it, a hotel in York. So we got the train there and we're in this hotel, it was lovely. And then that evening in the hotel, we're saying we'd have been flying tomorrow to Corfu from Manchester Airport. Said, yeah, and we were, never mind, we'll have a good time in York. So that night we went to a room after a night in the pubs in York, fell asleep, and I had a real vivid dream. It was horrible. Standing by the bed, right next to me, was this figure, like a man, and when I looked into his face, his body. It was burnt, it was smoking, coming off him. He sat up upright, looked right at him, and he was just staring right at me. I could smell like the burnt, to be truthful, like burnt bacon. And this smoke just coming off him. And he had this, his face was horribly burnt. I thought, oh. I put my head down on the pillow. I thought, was that real? Have I just seen that apparition? Was it? What was it? Opened my eyes again to see, and I think it was gone. I thought, oh, it's a horrible dream, that. Oh, I put my head back on the pillow and eventually got back to sleep. Next day, in the morning, the wife, the girlfriend, who would soon be my wife, actually, she wakes up. Well, I'm in the bed and she goes, had a horrible dream last night, Dave. Oh, it was terrible. I said, oh, what was it? She said, well, I woke up and standing next to the bed was this man. And he was all burnt, he had smoke coming from him. I said, what? She said, yeah, it was horrible. It was so scary. I said, I had exactly the same dream. I said, and he was about 6 foot tall. She said, yeah. Just standing. I said, just staring at you. She said, yeah. I thought, oh my word. It's very, very spooky. We both looked at each other and went with a little shiver of our spines and said, wow, even dreaming the same things now. And we got ready for breakfast, showered, put the clothes on, down for breakfast. It was 9 o'clock. Goes down. And as we're down there, the eggs getting ready, the woman from the hotel was talking to other people from the hotel, and she said, oh, did you hear? Hear what? Plane from Manchester going to Corfu on takeoff. Caught fire and crashed. Oh my God. Looked at each other. I think we both went white, pale. I said, excuse me, what was that? I said, oh yes, just been a news flash. The plane, Manchester going to Corfu, crashed, caught fire. Don't know how many people were killed yet. It just happened. And we thought it couldn't have been our flight. Couldn't have been the one we missed. And we checked the time and it was. That was the plane that we should have been on. That should have been us. Because of a double booking, we missed that flight. We thought the man in our dream burnt side of the bed. Yes, was that the person who took our places? Well, I don't know. But what I do know is, we should have been on that flight. Could have been us that were burnt alive, taken off on a fateful journey to Corfu. Maybe it wasn't our turn. Maybe the man was standing there to just say, this could have been you, but it wasn't your turn. We survived. And we got calls, frantic calls, from family and friends who all thought we were on that plane. And they were upset, worried, saying, thank God we're still alive. We thought you were on that plane. Well, we survived. I survived. And I never take anything for granted. And believe it or not, I'm not scared of flying. I'm not scared of anything these days, because I think someone's looking over me and my girlfriend. And we were protected by guardian angel or whatever. Fickle finger of fate saved us. The double booking. So, never ever assume that life's mapped out for us. Sometimes when we go on our journeys, we never arrive to that designated place. Maybe we end up somewhere different. Heaven or hell. Suppose I was lucky, alive, to tell this true Scouse scary story. Factual. And thank you for listening. My name's Dave Kelly. This was, of course, the Manchester air disaster, 1985, that changed people's lives, how we fly safely on planes. It certainly changed my life.